Did you know that the Casablanca in Mesquite was the number one getaway in Southern Nevada? With over 792 slots and 24 hot table games and a full-service racing sports book, we have a 24-hour coffee shop, a world-class spa and salon featuring couples treatments. Come Labor Day weekend for barbecue championships and Zoe Bowie poolside. So call 877-GETAWAY and book your room, golf, or spa now. Just $79. But you're not here yet?
Who's ready for a main event? Let's bring out the blue corner, Jeremy Umlin.
Resort and Casino here in Mesquite, Nevada. My name is John Morgan, and I am alongside Aaron True tonight for Tough Enough, the future stars of mixed martial arts, and it has all come down to this. We are ready for our main event, and Aaron, bust out your cliches. We need the reinforced cage, the big boys are banging, whatever you want to use, because this is a super heavyweight title fight. And we meet first our undefeated challenger, 2-0 Jeremy Umlin.
And he's fighting out of Minnesota, listed at 2-0, but does have some unsanctioned fights where he is also undefeated. So a little more experience than is technically sanctioned. And what we're going to see here tonight is not just two sloppy super heavyweights. As Charles West's opponent, or Charles Williams would say, you're going to see two big guys with skill, technique, and heart, and who are actually in shape.
That's exciting to hear. You know, obviously, it's the super heavyweight division in the past of mixed martial arts has sometimes just been basically the home of dudes that didn't really feel like training. A bunch of big guys that didn't want to bother to cut down to 265. But that is not the case anymore. We're starting to get these massive athletes who are taking this serious. Jeremy Umlin has been training for the past 5 years. Same's been kind of off and on over the past few years, but he's really kind of taking it serious now, working jiu-jitsu. He trains with Brock Larson, obviously a longtime veteran who we've seen great things out of in the past. Says his favorite old school fighter is Dan Severn. So really looking at everything in all aspects of fighting, even at that big division, this big division of the super heavyweights. Now, with all that said, the technique, hopefully the cardio that we're going to see, I mean, in the super heavyweight division, it's the guy that lands first, right?
Pretty much. Just now in the cage, someone said, who do you think is going to win? And I said, whoever gets hit first is going to lose because both of these guys have knockout power. Both of these guys win pretty much every fight by KO.
Yeah, when you're 300-plus pounds, you usually pack a little bit of a punch. Jeremy Umlin with the Stomp MMA squad is making his way into the cage now, and he is hoping to head back to Minnesota with a championship belt. Maybe laid over his shoulder. I don't know if he'll be able to wrap it around his waist or not, but at least laid over his shoulder.
For a 300-pounder, though, pretty good shape.
Corner, Charles Williams.
And now our defending Tough Enough super heavyweight champion, Charles Chucky Williams, about to make his way out here to the cage. And John, you've called this guy's fights before. You've seen him win title fights here at Tough Enough. What are we going to expect to see from Charles Williams?
Yeah, Chucky Williams at 6'1", 27 years old, is a big, strong dude. He knows how to throw hands. Again, he has some athleticism. It's not just a sloppy, big dude, but it's somebody with technique as well. But again, it's all about the power. The strength that this man possesses means that if he catches you flush, you will go down.
And Charles Williams, he is coming out here with a 5-0 record, 4 knockouts. But not only is he a devastating fighter with great knockout power, he's a really great human being. He came to the last event with his 2-year-old son. And in this fight, he spent a year working on an endorsement deal with Playboy Energy Drink. So he's coming in now sponsored by Playboy Energy Drink as a super heavyweight champion.
That's incredible to see. Obviously, Tough Enough has long been the home of the highest level amateur mixed martial arts. And these two fighters, you know, both show that maybe there is a future in super heavyweight. We always hear UFC President Dana White saying, you know, we'll never see super heavyweights in the UFC. And I think that's probably the right decision, at least for now. I think the heavyweight division is really just starting to fill out. But maybe in the future there is a home for super heavyweights because deny the fan factor in super heavyweights. I mean, you know, we're trying to sell these flyweights and bantamweights who have exciting fights, but fans, when they see two monsters in the cage, they just get it.
Everybody here is loud as can be. We can barely hear each other here in the commentating booth because everybody's so excited to see 800 pounds in the cage. The two fighters and referee combined over 800 pounds. Everybody loves super heavyweights because the fight can end at any time with one punch.
That's right. Just takes one. Getting checked out by Joe Williams.
Actually saw Charles Williams at the buffet before weigh-ins. He was the only fighter lucky enough to be able to eat before the weigh-ins, actually.
That.
He said he weighed 320 before the buffet and weighed 328 at weigh-ins.
Charles Williams, the champion, comes in to defend his belt.
Our ISK representatives for the evening are Ralph Cook and President Corey Schaefer. Timekeeper Craig Michi, scorekeeper Mark Beecher, and judges cageside are Jimmy Bice, Steve Steele, and Terrell Potter. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. Scheduled for three 3-minute rounds, all for the Tough Enough Super Heavyweight Championship. Fight fans, it's about to go down. Introducing first in the blue corner, with two wins and no loss, fighting out of Stomp MMA, Wadena, Minnesota, the challenger, Jeremy Omlin. Standing across the cage in the red corner, undefeated with 5 wins, fighting out of ATF MMA, Las Vegas, Nevada, he is the defender, Charles Williams. Referee in charge of the action is Mark Smith.
All right, gentlemen, super heavyweight title. Got your instructions earlier. Protect yourself at all times. Obey my commands. Touch gloves now at the bell. Be ready to fight.
So Umlin, the challenger in black and yellow. Williams, the champion in black and gray. Both possess knockout power. Let's see what happens.
Jeremy Umlin already loading up on the right hand. The fight hasn't even started yet.
Here it comes.
Comes out swinging.
Umlin, super aggressive right away.
Big right hand counter
against the cage.
Or drops him. Williams on top.
Hammer fist there. Big left hand. And that's going to do it.
Huge right hand counter. Drops Umlin. Able to finish him off. Incredible victory.
Mark Smith came in to stop the fight. Umlin not happy with the decision, but he was getting mauled by Charles Williams, who, as you said, defended the early bull rush, landed a counter shot, and just wailed with hammer fists.
And the way you described that as early on as a bull rush, I really think there's no other way really to say that. He came out, he had the right hand loaded before the fight even started, came out rushing him, put the pressure on and put the heat on, and Williams landed an incredible, staggering counter right hand.
You can see Williams celebrating, obviously a happy man. Williams says that he eventually wants to perhaps even be a light heavyweight at some point in his career. He's got a long way to go to get down to there, but he's having a lot of fun at super heavyweight in the meantime. You see the sportsmanship here. We said it going in the super heavyweight division, anything can happen. And this is what we saw here. The right hand counters coming off, the left as well, but it was the big right that put Umlin on the floor, and then in came the hammer fist. Mark Smith, you can see, was right there, was calling for some kind of defense, some kind of answer for Umlin, who didn't think he was hurt bad enough to lose the fight, but just wasn't responding. So Charles Williams keeps his belt. Let's take it up the cage, get the official time.
Ladies and gentlemen, hold on, this is gonna be good. After 10 seconds into the first round, your winner by knockout, Charles Williams, and still Tough Enough Super Heavyweight Champion.
Charles Williams keeps the belt in 10 seconds. Incredible. incredible
I hate
finish.
That song.
Let's
I always feel like they're talking to me.
I am here with the defending super heavyweight, tough enough champion, 10 second victory here tonight. What took you so long?
I mean, I had the opportunity. First of all, let me thank God. Let me thank my mom, Heather, Tristan, my dad. Let me thank Playboy Energy Drink. Let me thank ATF, Angelo, for the wrestling. Nikki, thank you for coming. I appreciate it very much. And the fans, y'all are awesome. We want to do this again in Mesquite. But I had the opportunity to talk to Mr. Umlin for 3 hours. I mean, we made a great friendship. So there's no hard feelings here.
I saw a lot of mutual respect between both of you at the weigh-ins. He came out rushing you early, early onslaught. You had to withstand that early rush. You landed a huge counter right hand. Walk us through how you finished the fight.
Well, I had a feeling because the ref had told me that he said he didn't want to touch gloves in the beginning. So I had a feeling he was going to come out and try to hit me hard. So I just stepped back. So then he had to come closer again and meet the hook. And then from there, I just kept throwing punches. When he hit the ground, I just wanted to keep throwing punches over and over and over again.
Every time we see you at Tough Enough, we see an impressive knockout. Are we going to be able to see you again soon?
Yes, yes. I was 350 pounds last time. I'm 328 pounds this time. I should be about 300 pounds, 290, and we're going down.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear a big hand for the Tough Enough defending super heavyweight champion, 10-second knockout, 10-second TKO victory, Charles Williams.
So Charles Chucky Williams, your defending super heavyweight champion. Impressive work yet again.
Thank
he stood
all
the early barrage
from
Jeremy Umlin and defended his belt. Another great night of fights here at the Casablanca Resort and Casino in Mesquite, Nevada. Tough Enough, the future stars of mixed martial arts, delivers yet again. Always top-notch MMA action. For Aaron True, my name is John Morgan. For the Myers brothers and everybody behind the scenes that makes this thing happen, thank you for watching Tough Enough. We'll see you again next time with the future stars of mixed martial arts.